لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك وصلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحابته الغر الميامين والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله من النار آمين آمين أولا عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله فقد فاز المتقون حيث قال الله سبحانه أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال أيضا ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله وقال أيضا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما اللهم اجعلنا من المتقين والفائزين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed, indeed it's a blessing to gather here on a Friday and we should praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost for every blessing that He has bestowed upon us, alhamdulillah. We send our blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah be pleased with his entire household, his companions, and those who strive to serve the message of Islam until it reached to all of us. May he bless us all also. Ameen, ameen. The paramount reminder that we remind one another in every Friday is that we should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalimatu at-taqwa mushtaqqatun min waqa yaqi. The word at-taqwa is derived from waqa yaqi. What does it stand for? When we say taqwa, it means fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being conscious of Him. But the main translation of waqa, where it comes from, the root of the word itself, it stands for safeguarding and protection. But the question is, protection from what? Safeguarding from what? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us that we should fear Him or be conscious of Him, that means we prioritize Him in our lives. Before we do anything, prior to doing anything, we look into what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do. Is it a prohibition? We do not proceed. Is it a command that we have to do it, an obligation? We proceed from there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as a promise to me and you, for those who will fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be conscious of Him, He will amend their deeds and forgive them their sins. There is nothing greater than our sins being forgiven in our lives. And for those who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger, they have attained a great attainment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Ameen. We are in a blessed month, Shahr Sha'ban, Shahr Turfa'u al-A'mal ila Rabbil Alameen. We are in a month that our deeds are lifted to Allah the Almighty. This month is among the blessed months that we have in our Muslim calendar. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam committed himself in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for many reasons. But there are specific reasons. عن أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنهما قال قلت يا رسول الله لم أرك تصوم شهرا من الشهور ما تصوم من شعبان. Reported by Usama bin Zayd, he says, asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I said, I haven't seen you, O the Messenger of Allah, fasting in any other month, more like how you fast in the month of Sha'ban. Why do you do that? Why is that so? Now listen to the response of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We will find out that there were specific reasons, major reasons why he did this. What were the main reasons? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam responded back by saying, ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ بَيْنَ رَجَبْ وَرَمَضَانِ. That is a month which people do not pay attention to between Rajab and Ramadan. Which month is between Rajab and Ramadan? The month of Sha'ban. وَهُوَ شَهْرٌ تُرْفَعُ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And it is a month which our deeds, or deeds, are lifted to Allah, the Lord of the worlds. Subhanallah. فَأُحِبُّ أَن يُرْفَعَ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. And I love that my deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are ascended to Allah, and I am in the state of fasting. La ilaha illallah. Why did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam have to tell Usama bin Zayd these specific words? Let's look into the hadith. Let's break it down slowly, bit by bit. If you look at the verses of it, we'll find out, if we try to explain it into too much depth, the hadith itself, we won't be able to finish it all due to the heavy load of the information inside it. The hadith carries a lot of information, and they are so heavy. We cannot finish it all, but we will take the main parts of it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ بَيْنَ رَجَبْ وَرَمَضَانِ. People don't pay attention on it. One main reason that we have to pay attention on the month of Sha'ban is that we have reached our tax, or at the end of our year of tax. Now it's time to be taxed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all know when we reach April, a self-employed person, a person with a business, with anything, that's the time the HMRC come looking for us, follow us behind our tails. They want our annual report on our income. We all know that. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on the flip side, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants now to know about our deeds. Our deeds have to be lifted to Him. The question is, what have we done throughout the year? ترفع الأعمال إلى رب العالمين في ثلاثة أحوال أو في ثلاثة أوقات. Our deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala three times or three periods in a year. They are either lifted during the day, whatever we did during the night, they will be lifted on the day. And whatever we commit during the day, they will be lifted in the evening. And then the second time, or the second period, is weekly, in a weekly basis, every Monday and every Thursday. And then in an annual basis, it is every Sha'ban. How have we lived our year for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is giving us a method over here to tell us that us as human beings, we should always, always have a checklist in our lives and check into ourselves what we are doing in a daily basis. تُرْفَعُ الْأَعْمَالِ يَوْمِيًا. Our deeds are lifted every single day. Twice. Do we have a checklist for that?
تُرْفَعُ أَعْمَالُنَا أُسْبُوعِيًّا. Our deeds are lifted in a weekly basis. Do we have a checklist for that? تُرْفَعُ أَعْمَالُنَا سَنَوِيًّا. Our deeds are also lifted in an annual basis. Do we have a checklist for that? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us this so that we can wake up. ذَلِكَ شَهْرٌ يَغْفُلُ النَّاسُ عَنْهُ بَيْنَ رَجَبُ وَرَمَضَانُ. People don't pay attention in the month of Sha'ban. That is the sad thing about us Muslims. We do not pay attention on this month, not knowing the fact that our deeds are being lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the truth is, we are being taxed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's different. How is that? مَنْ جَاءَ بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ عَشْرُ أَمْثَالِهَا. Whoever comes with a good or righteous deed, he will be rewarded tenfold. وَمَنْ جَاءَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ فَلَا يُجْزَى إِلَّا مِثْلَهَا. And whoever will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a single evil act, he will be rewarded according to that act. Not tenfolded, only once. So now look. Us as human beings, when we are taxed, obviously there's a percentage we have to pay. Me and you. No matter who we are, either an employee, a businessman, self-employed, it doesn't matter. But with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if our books are full of good deeds, Allah rewards us tenfold. But if our books contain evil acts inside them, He will keep them the way they are. That's the mercy He has upon us. And the month of Sha'ban is the month that we have to pay attention, knowing that now we have reached to the end of the year. So perhaps if there is something missing, we fill it in. But then if we go to the second part of the hadith, فَأُحِبُّ أَن يُرْفَعَ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. I would love that my deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am in the state of fasting. We should ask ourselves, among all of the types of worships or ibadat that we have, لماذا خصص الله خصص النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عبادة الصوم. Why did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم have to specify fasting? The act of fasting by itself. He loved to fast on the Mondays and Thursdays due to specific reasons. And one of them, because he knew that his deeds were lifted on those specific days. تُعْرَضُ الْأَعْمَالِ يَوْمِ الْإِثْنَيْنِ وَيَوْمِ الْخَمِيسِ فَأُحِبُّ أَن يُعْرَضَ عَمَلِي وَأَنَا صَائِمٌ. Our deeds, or deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are taken to Allah on the days of Mondays and Thursdays. And I love that my deeds are lifted to Allah, whereas I am in the state of fasting. And he says the same thing in the month of Sha'ban. Scholars say, because Sawm or fasting, nobody can ever be proud out of it. Nobody can show off. Nobody can tell anyone that I am fasting, whereas we don't know the truth behind it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa alimu sirri wal alad. He is the one who knows what is hidden and what is explicit. So if we fast, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is the one who will know. Nobody else will know. وَثَانِ السَّبَبْ. And the second reason, it's because look at all the four acts that we have to commit in every hadith. The four acts which are from the five pillars of Islam. As-salah, wa-zakah, wa-sawm, wa-al-hajj. The non-Muslims or the non-believers, the Quraysh before, they used to pray to their idol worship, to their idols. كانوا يركعون. وَيَنْحَنُونَ إِلَىٰ أَصْنَامِهِمْ. They used to do what? They used to prostrate, bow down to their idols before. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam a method of praying, which was kind of the same as what they did. So which means if we do something, it's either we do it for the sake of Allah or for other reasons. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us do things because of Him. Ameen. But then if you look at zakah, somebody could give charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for any other reason. And then it becomes a shirk. May Allah forbid. But then when it comes to hajj, at-tawaf, the non-believers yesterday, they did tawaf, but they did it for the sake of their idols. But throughout history, عبر التاريخ, ما في أحد صام لغير الله. There is no one who fasted because of any other reason besides for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And do we know one fact? The other reason why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam chose fasting as a specific act on the day that his deeds or the month that his deeds will be lifted to Allah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ إِلَّا الصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجِزِي بِهِ. Every act of the son of Adam is his. But صوم, but fasting, except for fasting. The act of fasting is for him. Indeed, it's for me. And I will reward him for that. Why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have to specify it for this reason? Because Allah knew nobody would fast for any other reasons but for the sake of him alone, and alone it will be for him. Allahu Akbar. Is there anyone who would say today that he will abstain from drinking and eating and everything that is permissible for him just for the sake of someone? لا حاشا وكلا. It's impossible. But if we do so today, then we do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who do things for the sake of Him. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وخلانه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed we are in a blessed month, the month of Sha'ban. And we are at the end of our year or tax year at the moment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking into our deeds, what we have done throughout the year and what we can do for now. Let's leave the premises today or the khutbah today with only three things that we can do. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Indeed, in the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a very good example. That is for me and you. What do we take from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What did he used to do in the month of Sha'ban? The first thing we can do, we can start fasting from now. Why fasting? Remember that our deeds, they are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we would want our deeds to go to Allah while we are in a state of escorting it in a good way. Doing an act which we can do it just for Allah alone. We escort our deeds with an act that we can do it just for Allah alone. Why so in specific? Second reason, the month of Ramadan is ahead of us, is in front of us. We can prepare from now. نصوم حاليا لرمضان كصلاة النفل. We fast now for the sake of Ramadan, the same as praying an optional or additional prayer before an obligatory one. Before we do the, we perform the obligatory prayer, we perform a nafil. We all do that, right? Then we can do from now a preparation for Ramadan. Sawm in specific. Second thing, what we can do, we make sure our relationships with others, they are intact and good enough. We establish grounds that we will not untie our brotherhood or sisterhood in Islam. We are in this state because of division. There are many divisions out there today. And did you know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, تعرض الأعمال يوم الاثنين ويوم الخميس, that our deeds are lifted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every Monday and every Thursday, and every servant of Allah is paid accordingly or rewarded accordingly as long as that person has not associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except for one type of person or two type of people. Because it's between two people, or even more. Those who hold grudges between each others, their deeds are stopped. They are never lifted to Allah. To the extent now, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, that Allah says, أَنظِرُوا هَذَيْنِ حَتَّى يَصْطَلِحَا. Wait for these two until they amend themselves. They come into good terms. And the last thing, what we can do, read as much Quran at the moment like the Salaf al-Salih did. The past of the righteous ones, what they did, that's what we can do now. One of the righteous persons who passed, he used to close his shop in the month of Ramadan and not do anything, but just read Quran and fast, preparation for Ramadan. Those three things, if we leave with them, we are ready prepared for Ramadan. Ala wa sallu wa sallimu ala rasulillah kama amara Allah subhanahu. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammad. كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضي الله على الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين وعلى سائر صحابة رسول الله أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم, وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم, واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين الأحياء منهم والميتين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم, ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
لا إله إلا الله, لا إله إلا الله.